Well, I came to this unit and they said the AC is not working. I put my gauges on it, and before I put my gauges on it, it was reading maybe 5 or 10 PSI. And when I put the gauges on the low side, this went to zero. So the gauges had more pressure than the unit did. So now I'm going to put some pressure on it and see if we can find a leak. Hopefully it's out here so I don't have to crawl up in the attic. But we all know most of the time it's in the evaporator coil. So let's find out where it's at. Well, I didn't hear nothing outside, so it's time to go upstairs and look up in the attic and see if we hear anything up there. All right, I was going to spray it first, but I figured take the chance of it still has some refrigerant in it and see what the good old H10 says. Well, looks like I don't need to spray anything. The good old H10 is going to come through again. Yep. Got leaks all over this thing. Alright, now, fun part is trying to find a model and serial number since somebody has torn it off. Nice. Well, since I can't find the model number, serial number inside the unit or outside of the unit, no paperwork whatsoever, and it's definitely the coil is leaking, I recommended them and told them the best thing to do is just change this air handler. Because the time it takes me to take the coil out and take it somewhere and find out what size coil and everything else it is and to match it and all, the labor, the footwork, it'd be cheaper on them just to go ahead and get this thing changed out. So that's what I'm going to recommend. Now I'm going on to the next one.